very sort of minor detail, the scented herbs and flowers and other things and your food. Now the reason behind this is that Almighty is drawing your attention towards the waqimul wazna bil qist wa la tuksirul mizan, that you observe, measure. What it is that physically and spiritually, or politically and spiritually, we maintain a balance of life. Now today we are suffering because we have failed to maintain that balance which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has directed towards us. And I am sure that this multi-faith is drawing closer. As we are the worldwide community, we are getting closer, our understanding will increase, and also our absorption and our obedience to the Creator will obviously enlighten within ourselves. It will be easier for us. The other revelation, you see, which I want you to draw your particular attention, is this was the revelation given to the children of Israel, Bani Israel. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in this revelation, and remember when we made a covenant with the children of Israel saying, worship none save Allah, only be good to parents, and be good to parents and to kindred and to orphans and the needy, and speak kindly to mankind, and establish worship and pay the poor due. Now in this revelation, you see, this is also a remembrance of the God Almighty, that duty which we have in the light of the divine guidance towards other human beings. So in this category we have parents, we have people who are our relatives, we have kindreds and poor in the society, and also as a general public, Almighty is directing us to be kind to them, and that is also a part of the remembrance of our Creator. Now why we slip off is that when we go into the selfishness and disobedience, we turn away from our parents. And one of the very thing which is revealed in the Quran about the Jesus was that he said he is kind to his mother. Now this is what we have to understand, to be nice and kind to each other and see what the society needs. And I'm sure the Lord Mayor has very plainly put it to us, the effort which the council is making to materially make us well off. So we have to ourselves strive to be spiritually well off. Now, if we fail to maintain that balance, then obviously we will suffer at one stage or another in life. We only be half the man. Now, from the Prophet Adam alayhi salam, Prophet Ibrahim, and Prophet Zachariah, but one of the story which appeals to me very much is the one from the Prophet Zachariah. Now, the Quran gives the extracts from the of the story of the Zachariah in the following way. A mention of the mercy of thy Lord unto his servant Zachariah, saying, my Lord, lo, the bones of me wax feeble and my head is shining with grey hair. Now I am onto the chart if you want to look through. With grey hair, and I have never been unblessed in prayer to thee, my Lord. Lo, I fear my kinsfolk after me, since my wife is barren. O give me from thy presence a successor who shall inherit of me and inherit also. Said unto him, O Zachariah, lo, we bring thee tidings of a son whose name is John. We have given the same name to none before him. He said, my Lord, how can I have reached infirmed old age? He said, so it will be. Thy Lord said, it is easy for me, even as I created thee before when thou was not. He said, my Lord, appoint for me some token. He said, the token is that thou with no bodily defect shall not speak unto mankind 3 nights. Then he came forth unto his people from the sanctuary and signified to them, glorify your Lord at break of dawn and fall of night. Now this is a splendid sort of signal which he gave to me. So serve me and establish worship for my remembrance. So you can see from Zachariah, Prophet Adam alayhi salam, to Zachariah, and then coming on to the Prophet Moses, you know, Almighty instructing him that you establish the worship for my remembrance, which means that all material and other selfish benefits must go out, that his devotion must be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a complete devotion without any self-interest, only to achieve the pleasure and the blessing of Almighty. In the same way, Prophet Isa, Jesus alayhi salam, gave direction to his people, "Lo, Allah is my Lord and your Lord, so worship him, that is the straight path." Now in that remembrance, as far as the Jews, Christians or Muslims are concerned, there is obviously no difference in us. We all make effort, a united effort, to please God Almighty and to remember and be with him. And I can say from my personal experience that I have gained a great deal of understanding of God Almighty through looking at the Christian side of it as well. Now being a Muslim, fair enough, man is happy, but when he sees himself in the mirror of the other people, then he is able to improve himself and make a forward strive in which he gains more blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last of the messengers, he was given the command, "And though Muhammad, remember thy Lord within thyself humbly and with awe, below thy breath at morning and evening, and be thou not of neglectful. Lo, those who are with thy Lord are not too proud to do him a service, but they praise him and adore him." So you can see the language which is used by Almighty, that they praise, at the same time they have a love and the affection and the adoration for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for their creator. The benefits of the remembrance of God are numerous. From my study of the Christian side, the Jewish and the Muslim side, and the thorough study of the Quran reveals to me that there are countless benefits. For instance, for a start, we have to resort to artificial means to achieve peace within ourselves, whereas it is given freely to us. And Almighty speak, "Verily, the remembrance of Allah do hearts find rest." So there is a rest for us for a start, that we are contented, we are happy, we are joyful when we are with our Lord. Also, the protection which is offered, and he whose sight is dimmed to the remembrance of the Beneficent, we assign unto him a devil who becometh his comrade. Now the neglecting of the duty to Almighty, turning our back onto him, is not appreciated. Because in the earlier surah which I mentioned to you, from the jewels and diamonds and many other things of the visible world, the Almighty, the gift which he has in the visible sort of sense, and in invisible gift, bounties which he has restored for us, Almighty speak. And then if we, in spite of all those favors and blessing and bounties which he have created for us, we neglect Almighty, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to favor that. So we have to bear our duty of the rewards which we are getting, and in view of the gratitude of the rewards which we are receiving, we remember our Lord. Now purification, our holy prophet said that for everything there is a mean of purification. The purification of the heart is through remembrance of Allah. Now here people suffering the heart disease, their blood clotting, myocardial infarction and many other diseases which are there because due to the impurity of the blood, the system is not clean enough. So here, which I have put myself into practice, and many of them in the past mystical men have, we are getting a free medicine which will give us a peace and also contentment, but at the same time will purify our heart. So it is through the purity of the